Hi, I'm Nerida. Welcome to chefmasterclasses.com. Very excited to introduce you to this beautiful man standing beside me.
Very kind.
This is Stuart McVeigh from number 35 at the Sofitel on Collins Street in Melbourne. Now, I'd like you to also meet Kevin. Kevin the Kingfish.
Absolutely.
So, you caught this fresh this morning.
I did, yes.
Not really. Tell me how Kevin came to be.
We get him through our fish supplier.
Yep.
The good thing about Kevin is that he's a farm fish, and I suppose in some ways it's a good thing because, you know, we're all worried
sustainable.
About sustainable. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Which is one of the reasons we use him. Also, he's extremely delicious.
Oh, yeah.
Very meaty, great fat content, mm-hmm. very versatile. So he's a perfect thing to have on the menu.
Now, how heavy is he?
He's about 3 kilos.
Okay. If I bought a fish like this from the fishmonger and I wanted to prepare it to make your dish,
yes.
I think I could probably manage to carve it up if it was cooked, because it's a whole different ball game. But doing it raw, hacking.
Sure.
Not a good idea.
So well, you need to show me. Knowing where to cut is a good thing.
That's right.
And always your fishmonger will be very happy to, so you want to obviously get it scaled, will be a great thing.
Yep.
And
cleaned.
Clean the guts.
Yep. Oh, doesn't look too clean to me.
That's good, really, because all the belly's been removed and intestines, so that's a good thing.
Okay.
So I'm right-handed, so I'm going to start with the head down this end.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just going to bump
across a little bit. Oh, sorry. Yeah, sure.
So always just going to make a little incision just near the tail.
Yeah.
And where I've got my fin here, I just want to bring my knife in underneath.
Yeah.
And then we can come around under there. Now we can already see a beautiful...
Yeah.
Marbling through there. It's almost like, you know, marbling you're expecting Wagyu beef.
Mm.
It's really, really sensational. Got really fantastic flavour. Like the belly from the kingfish has got so much flavour.
Mm.
Can be used for a variety of things.
So are you going to eat this bit as well?
We're not going to use that today, but you can break these off.
Yeah.
And then slow cook them is really good, and then eat the meat.
Okay.
Or if you use guys with modern technology, I suppose, and the water bath cookery and sous vide cookery.
Oh, yeah.
You clean it and remove the bone and just put it into a little bag with olive oil and slow cook it.
Mm.
So it's perfect in temperature, so about 44 degrees.
Beautiful.
And then put it in the pan and just caramelize it, and it just melts in your mouth.
Beautiful. Or stock, of course.
Absolutely. And the head's very good for stock as well, as long as you remove the eyes.
Right. Okay.
Okay.
I don't think I can remove the eyes.
It's a glamorous job, that's for sure. We're going to run the knife straight down the backbone.
Uh-huh.
Then we've got a flat bone running through to the ribs. So we're going to come straight through to the ribs. We're going to cut straight through the ribs.
Mm-hmm.
And when we clean a fish, we just want to make sure that we keep our knife straight. So we always know we're cutting against the bone, we're not cutting into the fish.
Okay.
And a knife which has got a little bit of give is always a good thing.
Right.
So we're just going to make our incision into the fish.
Mm-hmm.
And just run down.
Because you don't want to be wasting it either.
No, absolutely. So we're going to come straight in now to the middle of the fish. Just taking it slowly. You can hear the bones.
Yeah.
That's what we want. Come over the tail. So here we can see we've cleaned it. We can see the bone there is perfectly clean. We haven't left any fish on there. That's exactly what we want. And then we're just going to come through the belly. Like this. Mind your fingers.
Oh, yeah.
We can clean that piece there. And now we can go straight through the ribs. So we're going to come up here. Through the ribs.
Gosh, that is perfect. Look at that.
And we've taken the fish off. We haven't left any...
Gosh, that is absolutely
flesh
perfect.
...flesh on the bone. And that's exactly what you want. You don't want to leave any meat on the bone. And we'll end up with a perfect fillet with no breakages or
fantastic.
Cuts.
Okay, and now how do we get it from there to...
Okay, I might just pop
looking all beautiful.
Kevin over here.
Yep.
So we've got this is our rib cage here.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to whip the rib cage up.
Mm-hmm.
And again, if we put our knife against these bones here, then we know we're not going to cut into our fish.
Oh, good idea.
And then just watching our fingers. Just remove those.
And there are little pockets of fat too, aren't there?
There's a lot of fat, and especially, as we said, like through the belly, there's a lot of fat there.
Mm.
And we'll just use slightly firm knife just to clean that very edge of the belly off. Pop them over there.
Fished off again.
Absolutely.
Mm.
And there we have our clean fillet. And as you can see, you've got all that beautiful marble in through the belly.
Yeah, it's gorgeous.
And the fish is really beautiful and clean. Now you can either, there's a line of bones which you get in majority of fish called the pin bones,
mm-hmm.
which you can remove for yep. normal, if you're going to cut through the fish and make a large portion
yep.
and roast it, and then yep. you'd use some tweezers or something similar just to pull those bones out. But today we're going to use the main loin plus a little bit of the belly maybe.
Great.
So we'll just clean straight down the bones.
Excellent.
All right, so we're going to come in just under the bones there.
Mm-hmm.
So we can see the bloodline runs along there.
Yeah. And it doesn't taste nice?
It's not superbly delicious, I have to say. And also aesthetically, it's
looks a
bit gross. Not very appealing. Mm. If someone's paying for a dish, they don't want to be getting the blood. They want to be getting the prime cut.
Yeah.
So we're just going to remove the skin off here now. So again, we just make a small incision on the base. Just run a knife straight along the bottom.
So wow.
Got the skin.
You're really good at this.
And you've got the bloodline there.
When I've tried to do this before, I've been hacking and ripping at it. It's been a nightmare.
A sharp knife is always a good thing to have.
Okay. Well,
definitely.
Next time I might just trot it into you and go, hi.
No worries. But your fishmonger could probably do all this for you anyway, if you wanted to.
Okay. All right.
So we just need to remove this final little piece of blood
yep.
and we're ready to go.
Excellent.
Just the remainder of it.
That is spectacular. Kevin's looking a little bit smaller and a bit more denuded now, but that is just the most beautiful looking piece of fish.
Absolutely.
So how many would this, for your dish that we're about to do for us, how many people would this do?
Oh, we'd get a generous sort of 6 to 8 portions.
Great. Okay, that's going to be at my next dinner party. All right, I'm going to step out now and leave you to it so you can show us how to make the dish.
No worries.
Thank you.